Miss O'Kaylee, back with the first chapter Friday, and I'm so glad that you joined me. Today I am bringing to you a book called Esperanza Rising by Pam Munoz Ryan, and it is one of my all-time favorite adolescent lit reads. It's so good. It's heartwarming, and it's sad, and it's funny, and it's everything a good book should be. It's all about a Mexican family who immigrates from Mexico into the United States, and they're farm workers, laborers, and it's just the story of this little girl who really misses the family that she has to leave behind and that she loses and is adjusting to this whole new life, and it's not an easy adjustment. So again, it's called Esperanza Rising, and I liked it enough that I named my daughter's middle name Esperanza, so you know it's a good one. I'm going to start off with the prologue, and we're just going to read that one, and I hope that it's enough to get you to go find this book. It starts off with Aguas Calientes, Mexico in 1924. "Our land is alive, Esperanza," said Papa, taking her small hand as they walked through the gentle slopes of the vineyard. Leafy green vines draped the arbors and the grapes were ready to drop. Esperanza was 6 years old and loved to walk with her Papa through the winding rows, gazing up at him and watching his eyes dance with love for the land. "This whole valley breathes and lives," he said, sweeping his arm toward the distant mountains that guarded them. "It gives us the grapes, and then they welcome us." He gently touched a wild tendril that reached into the row as if it had been waiting to shake his hand. He picked up a handful of earth and studied it. "Did you know that when you lie down on the land, you can feel it breathe? You can feel its heart beating." "Poppy, I want to feel it," she said. "Come." They walked to the end of the row where the incline of the land formed a grassy swell. Papa lay down on his stomach and looked up at her, patting the ground next to him. Esperanza smoothed her dress and knelt down. Then, like a caterpillar, she slowly inched flat next to him, their faces looking at each other. The warm sun pressed on one of Esperanza's cheek and the warm earth on the other. She giggled. "Shh," he said. "You can only feel the earth's heartbeat when you are still and quiet." She swallowed her laughter after a moment and said, "I can't hear it, Poppy." He said, "Wait a little while, and the fruit will fall into your hand. You must be patient, Esperanza." She waited and lay silent, watching Papa's eyes. And then she felt it. Softly at first, a gentle thumping, then stronger, a resounding thud, thud, thud against her body. She could hear it too, the beat rushing in her ears. Shoomp, shoomp, shoomp. She stared at Papa, not wanting to say a word, not wanting to lose the sound, not wanting to forget the feel of the heart of the valley. She pressed closer to the ground until her body was breathing with the earth's and with Papa's, the three hearts beating together. She smiled at Papa, not needing to talk, her eyes saying everything, and his smile answered hers, telling her that he knew she had felt it. They have a really sweet relationship, and she's really going to miss it later on in the book. So, find Esperanza Rising by Pam Munoz Ryan. Read it and tell me what you think.